गया। So our body the thickness 12 or 18 or 15 inch. So here temperature was minus 60. So here temperature is zero. That is what, na? So you can write from 18 to 15. So see the initial diagram. So here it is a hot layer, but below. Why this is warm? Because of
ozone.
It is a warm layer, it is not a cold layer. Compared to troposphere, here it is minus 60. But as you go up in the stratosphere, the temperature rises. It is opposite to the normal condition. That is because of the ozone layer. What is ozone layer? Where does it occur? Maybe 25 kilometers or 40 kilometers. That is the area, you know, where you will get the ozone. Something like that I will draw. So ozone layer consists of maximum 10 to 15 ppm of ozone. So when the ultraviolet light pass over it, it absorbs and becomes heated. That is the reason why the stratosphere is warm. Understood, na? How ozone forms? So it protects. That's why it protects us from UV radiation. UV radiation. No problem, na? Now you see how the ozone forms and remove this part now. Huh? It requires little explanation. See, ozone forms. This is how, you know, oxygen adds up with another monoatomic oxygen to form the ozone. As I told you in the tectonic class, you know, so during Archean times there was no oxygen in the atmosphere. Up to 2.5 billion years, there is no oxygen in the atmosphere. So where was the oxygen? Oxygen was in the water. Whatever oxygen, it was in the water. It was not in the atmosphere. So atmosphere was only the greenhouse gases. Carbon dioxide, methane, NO2, all these things were in the atmosphere. Up to 2.5. So whatever life initiated or continued, you know, they were in the water here. So they are mostly what is called anaerobic. Anaerobic means what? Without oxygen they can survive. So that type of life started in the water. They don't require oxygen to survive. So like, you know, stromatolites, different types of stromatolites. Have you seen any stromatolites?
Yes, sir.
Udaipur, have gone to Udaipur during your BC days?
Yes.
So that is the area, you know, where you will get lot of stromatolites in the Archean rocks. So they require no oxygen for their survival. But they produce oxygen, you know, for photosynthesis. So this is the beginning of atmospheric oxygen. You see how nature has put us in a you know very positive situation. You know, it created a life which does not require oxygen but produced oxygen for us. So that is why up to 2.5 there was no oxygen in the atmosphere. But after 2.5, you know, oxygen started appearing in the atmosphere. So you have oxygen now in the atmosphere from the Proterozoic onward. But before that, it was not there in the atmosphere. Follow this point. So even though you had oxygen in the atmosphere, it could not create life, it could not sustain life. Even though there was a lot of oxygen, gradually oxygen was built up. So what happened? Because we do not have ozone to protect us or protect the life. So that time life was continuing inside the water because ozone does not penetrate more than few meters. UV does not penetrate. UV does not penetrate much into the water. That is why life could persist, you know, or sustain inside the water. So during Proterozoic time, you had life in the water. During Archean time, it was in the water. So when this oxygen O3 started, so you went on, you know, till this period, in the Phanerozoic period. When this oxygen, we had so much of oxygen in the atmosphere, by then, you know, oxygen was built up in the atmosphere. So this ultraviolet ray from the sun made this reaction to start. So this ultraviolet ray fell on the oxygen, so oxygen become O plus O. And then this O combined with O forming O. That is how ozone was created. So again, the ultraviolet ray is responsible for creating the ozone. So ultraviolet ray created ozone in the stratosphere. Imagine it could have also created in the troposphere. So then no oxygen would have stayed, you know, here in the troposphere. So it was created exactly at a level, you know, so that the life could survive. You see? All right. So this is troposphere. So this is stratosphere. So somewhere here, the ozone layer was created. So now, the ultraviolet ray cannot penetrate. You are understanding these diagrams, na? This ultraviolet ray cannot penetrate. So the life could now survive on the land. Life on land. As well as in the sea, both exorbitant life started to grow. Because there is no UV ray for that person. So now, to understand the ozone story. You must have read about ozone depletion. Have you read about ozone depletion? Because this protects us, ozone layer protects us. So if you destroy it, if you destroy it, that is called, if ozone layer is destroyed, so you say it is depletion. So that means that 10-15 ppm, it comes down to from 1 or less, even less than that. So this happens because of this carbon CFC. This is what, na? CFC, na? What is the full form?
Chlorofluorocarbon.
chloro carbon. So this compound is used in refrigerators, sir. Understood or not? Freeze, refrigerators, air conditioners. Sometimes 1950, 1990, that time it was widely used. 1950 to 1990. See the period when this compound was excessively used, you know, in refrigerators and in air conditioners. So this element or this compound was emitted or discharged into the atmosphere. Okay. So CFC, it has this chlorine in it, you know. This chlorine reacted with the ozone, forming this ClO plus S. So ozone is broken down now. Then what happens, you know, this chlorine again reacts with ClO, reacts with, because oxygen has to be knocked out, you know, the another oxygen. For me, again monoatomic chlorine plus oxygen. So this again attacks. You are able to understand this ozone layer. That is how. See, so this chlorine is from CFC. This CFC gives off this chlorine. This chlorine attacks ozone, forming this compound ClO. Again, this ClO combines with monoatomic oxygen, forming again chlorine. So this chlorine is a chain reaction, product of this reaction. This chlorine again attacks with ozone, again this reaction starts. That is how, you know, ozone layer got depleted. So there was a treaty, you know, Montreal Treaty, where it was decided to ban CFC. You don't understand this mechanism, no? Why the ozone layer is getting depleted. The point is, now to some extent, you know, not fully, to some extent, the ozone layer is recovered. But it has its own inertia, no? I told you, once decay has started, I have explained you what is inertia. Once decay has started, it will continue for many years. So though we have recovered to some extent, but it is still going on. The depletion is still going on. So we have reduced, you know, the discharge of CFC into atmosphere. That was in our hand. But how much chlorine is there? Already it is there in the atmosphere, you know. Because this second step, you know, how can you control the second step? From here the chlorine is coming out. So this chlorine will again join with ozone. See, you are not destroying the chlorine in the stratosphere. You are only stopping this. Even you don't supply, but this reaction which has started, you know, long time back in 1950, that is still continuing. Follow this point, na? So we are not sure whether the ozone layer has been recovered fully or it is partly recovered, but definitely we have stopped this discharging process. This process we have stopped, but these equations or these reactions we have not stopped. That is why nowadays, you know, this atmospheric remote sensing, so satellite, they observe, they can map these layers, they can map different layers in the atmosphere. Understood? So ozone layer is mapped. There are some techniques. So they observe some ozone hole. What are those ozone holes? Suppose this is your Earth, I am drawing like this, you know. this is Antarctica, this is Antarctic, this is Arctic. So the ozone hole, so this is the ozone layer, you know. This is the ozone layer. They are not circular, as I told you. Now all layers comes closer, like this, you know, near the pole. Just like your troposphere comes down towards the pole, stratosphere also comes down towards the pole. This is a sloping surface. So here in the Antarctica, this atmospheric remote sensing, you know, they find some hole. Hole means the ozone layer is very thin now, from 15 ppm to say 1 ppm or even less. So if you see from here, your satellite is here, your satellite is here, you will find very thin ozone. Thin ozone over Antarctica. So that is called a ozone hole. Similarly, Arctic hole is there, or ozone hole at the Arctic, but not as extensive as the Antarctic. Arctic hole is there. Here. On this point,
sir. So why the hole is specially at that particular?
Only in the pole person. I am coming to that. I am just coming. Why not other places? You know, here why holes are not found? Why holes are not there? Why the holes are found in the pole region? That is what you are asking. I have come to that. No problem, na so far. Why they are polar? Why the ozone depression is polar? Understood, na? You do not find thinning of ozone here. Only thinning of ozone here. And they are continuing still today. We have not fully recovered. Though we are not emitting any. But still the ozone holes are being created. Now, this is called, there is a process, you know, called denitrification. This phenomenon you should remember. I am using my notebook. Just here. Some of the things. There is a process called denitrification. There is a process called denitrification. What is this denitrification? What it says, you know, see, chlorine emission to stratosphere is a natural phenomena during volcanic exhalation. You understand this part? During volcanic exhalation, HCl also emits. So chlorine bearing gases, you know, they are emitted into atmosphere during volcanic exhalation. So earlier time when volcanic eruption was so frequent, that time also chlorine was going into atmosphere, into stratosphere. So how the earth was taking care of that? Now CFC created a problem because we made it. But during natural volcanic eruptions, the chlorine was also going into stratosphere. So that must be also eating up ozone. So how earth was taking care of that? Is there any mechanism? So that mechanism is called denitrification. So this is a process, you know, which is taking care of the ozone depletion. Though chlorine was added into the atmosphere. So how it was doing? See, in the stratosphere, as well as we'll go to mesosphere also now. After stratosphere, we'll go to mesosphere. So they are very cold horizon, say 0°. The freezing point is stratosphere. Mesosphere is further freezing. So that means here water stays in the ice cap. Understood? So in this